losing health. CW in a position I would have expected him to be here, but it looks like he's not going to get punished.
CW with the Esmeralda, he knows he can get in, get out, no problem with the Frostmourne shield. He's totally fine, totally fine. He can dish out damage and also able to sustain amount of damage that's going to be coming to him. He's so confident as well. Early game, there's not going to be a major amount of damage either. Yeah. So he's totally fine with it. But CW is really level 4. He has a falling star moon. Let's see how well it's going to be going against it. Because right now, Phoenix with the Grok doesn't have not even level 3 yet. It's not even level 4 either.
I'm just so happy with this composition coming out of Onyx that it isn't your traditional hyper carry like what Aurifier is trying to do. Mm-hmm. Starmoon Falls jumps onto Phoenix and Phoenix realizes, hey, woo! I'm kind of squishy. I don't really want to keep this up despite having the red buff on it. But Vanstrong putting in quite a bit of damage into Drian here. They slowly pull back and they are really pressuring this bottom side jungle.
Dude, I just love it, like, especially like this is the answer they have. By the way, gonna be seeing Thrust getting a little bit too greedy there. He knows his Thanos. Previous game, he's definitely not Uranus anymore. He has to back off. He has to remember he's a Thanos. But CW, he's getting a little bit ill. Thanos is gonna be dropping down. First blood is gonna be drawn towards the Sire Aura Fire as our dear friend Vanstrong will be getting that first blood.
Yeah, that was real. Like, I didn't expect that much damage coming out of Vanstrong this early into the game, especially since he is a level down compared to CW as well. So that was pretty surprising to see him just like chunk him 50% of his HP while Vance just jumps immediately after with a quick follow-up.
Jesus Christ, man. Tassad not definitely not having the time of his life in this side lane as all. Anti-Mage just hiding the bush, like, hey, you're here. Just let's say hi. Dish out a couple of damage with my Ioning Edge and just go back to the bush.
Yeah, pushed up the lane. He is looking to find some kind of information or advantage inside. And wait a minute, did he steal? No, he did not steal the blue buff.
Oh man, if he stole that, that would be out of this world.
Yeah, are they going to punish him or not? No, it looks like Anti-Mage that we saw in game one.
Correct.
It just comes down to one bad fight and this might be it. Aura's Trust already getting chunked out a little bit here as they try to contest the River Crab. Vance jumping onto CW here. He needs a little bit of help. Vanstrong can't follow up. He's already dropped his second ability. And unfortunately, CW was able to use the Star Moonfall to bail out of that.
Oh man, I mean, that's pretty much Vance Bale saying, get out of my crab, you know, that's my crab. I'm going for the tower by the way. Ooh, Rusty as you, just, you know, just casually scaring people, like, with the perfect match. Like, hey man, I heard we're both matching each other on Tinder. Like, let's get a little bit closer with each other.
Yeah, it looks like Tazet, again, this matchup is just so impossible for him until he gets two items, and that's when he can really pop off against Anti-Mage, but no help from his team. He's just forced to kind of hold the lane for as long as possible against Anti-Mage. I think here he might be looking to try and chunk him out, but it's just impossible.
Dude, and the thing is, it's like, even if Aurifier were to choose to send someone to back him up as well on the top side, they actually will, you're going to be seeing, honestly, we're going to be committing a lot of fight. By the way, Fatal Lane is going to be pulling him all, thrust all the way back to the tower, but sadly, still not going to be enough, just too much damage coming for the side here. But this is what I mean, right? Like, if Aurifier choose to send a single member to assist Tassad at top side,
it's just wasted.
Yeah, it's going to be wasted. Honestly, Anti-Mage is going to back off. And honestly, this one is going to fully utilize that they're actually one man short here. And Anti-Mage, my god, like, Vance trying so hard. But Anti-Mage is just like, you see, he's easily healed up back to half HP.
Yeah, it's just the Rizla things, you know? And now Phoenix forced to clear out this wave. He might get dove under the turret here, especially against CW, who's really, really farmed up on top of the fact that Rossi put the power nature keeps him alive. He's trying to buy enough time. He quickly out of there. Yes, Phoenix lives. And Onyx, CW, and Rossi fail the dive. They quickly lose. They don't lose too much, but they have to retreat.
Yeah, but okay, I'm gonna be a little bit biased for like 2 seconds, like grok, 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 grok. Okay, anyway, gonna be coming back again. Drain gets jumped up, but able to back off instantly. That's the beauty about Lunas, right? Like, she does amount of damage in her light form, able to sustain most of the fight and try to immune amount of damage here. But we're coming back to the bot lane, my god, Trust is really getting punished over and over again. Rossi definitely not allowing Trust to even get a single amount of opportunity to get all the items he needed to commit towards that mid game.
I don't know. At this point, I feel like Masha should be the one going down into the bot lane, but they are utilizing Masha and the way that she can take out neutral creeps really, really quickly once she activates her empowered auto attacks. I guess that is a plus point for wherever the turtle spawns on the map, but again, these side laners are getting punished real hard.
Oh my god, dude.
Wow, I didn't think that Vance was going to die there, but yeah, I totally forgot that, you know, Sasa was a thing.
Oh man, yeah, Sasa is definitely a thing, man. I told you, man, as long as you have an Angela, tower dives look like they're just a common thing in MLBB. It's like clear, simple way, you know, the tower is just a design, you know.
Yeah,
it's interior design, man.
It's not looking good here because now it's going very Onyx favorite here as they will try and break this mid. They've already broken down bot. They've broken down top. Now they just need to get rid of this mid tier 1 and they'll have full control. control, and you can see just the vision from Aura Fire just decreasing back into the base. Instance.
Oh my god.
And CW and Anti-Mage this time. I thought it was going to be Rossi, but instead it was Anti-Mage. Again, side lane's getting heavily punished.
Yeah, dude. And the best part about it, Sasa already has the fleeting time as well. So definitely going to be getting hard. Definitely Sasa going to be getting that hard guard. Definitely off cooldown way faster than usual. Van's definitely trying his best to catch up with the farm himself. Although he is level 12. Highest, literally highest in the entire game, but still not, they're just not able to sustain because you see CW alongside with Rossi. Both of them super impactful regardless of what game they are in.
Yeah, and it looks like Aura Fire aren't sure what's the proactive play there. They're trying to play defensively. However, Onyx is not giving any opportunities, and once again, they're getting caught out in the jungle. You can't be there like that when you don't know where they are on the map, especially by yourself.
Yeah, I mean, just absolutely getting punished. Now Phoenix, although yes, he has his passive, makes him a little bit more tanky near the cliffs of walls, but eventually he has to leave that location, flickers out, but instantly gets that monster kill for the side here of CW, already with 6 kills on the belt here.
Yeah, Aura Fire, this is an unwinnable match for Tzet here. He just has to walk away. It's like, I have 3 health bars, but whatever, I still can't get through this freaking annoying anti-mage playing Uranus. God. And I think at this point, Aura Fire have, I wouldn't want to say lost the game already, but you can clearly see that they aren't sure how to play from behind against this aggression from Onyx Esports.
Oh my god, look, Tzet, oh yeah, he wants to do a little bit of damage, but just look at the amount of health he's getting back instantly as well. Oh my god, but anyway, coming down for the boss line as well. We see Phoenix coming with the wall challenge, but Sally, just no damage follow-up either. Although we see Sally Sasa trying to get out alive, and we can see already Vance trying to retaliate back. Couple of trades here, 2-1 here. Definitely Aura Fire fighting back in this kind of situation.
Oh my goodness, Van Strong, his damage. Looks like he's going to be the primary source of damage with, Von Strong being the primary source of damage while Van's looking to, you know, clean up the fight immediately after, because I was not expecting that much damage coming in from it. But now Anti-Mage might be in a little bit of trouble here. Drian there to save the day, to deter the rest of Aura Fire, to ruin Anti-Mage's perfect KDA.
Yeah, but Anti-Mage just regens him back in a couple of seconds, so.
Hey man, it's Uranus things.
Yeah, that's Uranus things, but just look at CW. Amount of shield, amount of damage, but Phelan is going to be dragging all 3 mana back away from the tower. But Sally Vance had another thing to say about it. Goes in the mix here. But oh my god, CW. Triple kill and instantly falls out with the Maniac and gets a savage instantly. 5-man wipe. And that was literally a 3v5. But Sasa also did assisted with the heart guard from the global ultimate skill. Jesus freaking Christ, man. Amen to the man here.
Yeah, that was a fat ultimate coming in from Rossi, initiating the fight, sacrificing his life, ruining his KDA just to allow CW to shine with the help of Sasa as well as Anti-Mage. Like, that follow-up, Anti-Mage Ionic Edge, just to slow them down enough so that CW can just cut them down one by one. And this is going to continue. Anti-Mage just dancing around as the rest of the team can't really do too much in clearing the waves as quickly as possible. But Aura is just so far behind, they can't stop this aggression coming in from Onyx Esports.
Oh god, dude, just shields for days, ladies and gentlemen. Even though they're hitting that middle tower, there's just no way for Aura Fire to even contest it. And even look at Vance, the main damage of the team here is trying to go toe-to-toe with Anti-Mage, but Anti-Mage just instantly regens it back, like, it's absolutely no problem. It's as if he's actually inside the fountain itself. By enemy coming down with the final push and final team fight as well. Hopefully it goes with a wall chance coming on the side here. Phoenix, here comes the Tempest, but the Fatal Lane is going to be pulling back again. Although Trust was able to get a couple of kills on himself, but Anti-Mage still falls back and retaliates. Drian starts to hold the fall here. Tzet finally coming online, but the puppets on the string, Sasa. Sasa just constantly just playing with Tzet, and Anti-Mage will seal the deal in his fate though. Drian's trying to go for a little bit more kills. Will get the mega kill for himself. Last man standing, Phoenix, although will he rise from the ashes? I'm not sure. He's not even trying to go back to the fountain because he knows the minute he leaves, that crystal won't break. He's trying to delay as much as possible, but Sally does not tank it enough. The crystal is slowly getting hit. And